an artist is inherently a creator. Someone who translates mental flashes and images in their brain into something that we can experience with our own eyes. Amanda Louise Spayd has a whole world that exists inside her head, and her gifts to us are the odd and beautiful creatures that populate it.
And it's like an orphanage here. It's like the halfway house for wayward creatures.
Each of Amanda's creatures are handmade and give off their own unique history and personality. However you might classify Amanda's work, it might seem as though you're making a strange new friend, and not just another art object to collect and put up on your wall.
I kind of imagine that they maybe inhabit a world that, you know, like maybe they come alive at night. I mean, you're sleeping, you don't know what happens. Like maybe they're eating crumbs from under the refrigerator, like dead bugs on the windowsill, like are they like eating your expired cough syrup? They're the character actors of the art world, and that you know, they're never the most beautiful, maybe they're not hunky, they always look nervous, they always look a little bit spooked, but you know, they don't know. It's a big world out there. I do feel very maternal about them, like I brought them into the world and it's important to me that I know that they're going to a safe place and that they won't be allowed to play in traffic, and someone will keep them from touching a hot stove, and they'll be all right.
Amanda's work is sought after by collectors all over the globe. Recently, she was sought after by director Christopher Cazellas. Cazellas contacted Amanda to make puppets for his upcoming stop-motion animation, The Maker.
Of course I said yes, because that's something that goes all the way back to childhood dreams of making puppets and seeing them alive and seeing them move, because it's one thing to have a beautifully crafted object sitting there that you look at and you're proud of and you're like, this exemplifies all the things that I want. But then to see it blink or turn its head or move or breathe was just amazing, and he's a very gifted animator.
Amanda's puppets were painstakingly animated by Zealous Creative, resulting in an absolutely gorgeous and touching short film. The Maker has gone on to screen at over 60 festivals worldwide and made one artist extremely happy.
I totally cried like a baby when I saw it for the first time, because it was kind of like, I knew it. Like, I knew they're real. Like, I told everyone they were real, and now I can prove it. Like, to see them moving and blinking and existing not as a still frame was really, really amazing. I'd love to do that again.
One can only hope to see Amanda's creatures come to life again, and her brood is growing. Recent shows in Columbus, Albuquerque, Chicago, New York City, and even in Japan have kept Amanda extremely busy finding new homes for her wayward creatures.
There's a world that I wish existed, and as an artist, I have a rare gift, and that gift is that I can make it. So I'm taking every opportunity I can to actually make this world in my brain happen. It's very exciting.
To watch the rest of The Maker, visit www.themakerfilm.com. You can find Amanda's work invading the internet and on her blog at mandylouise.blogspot.com.